Greetings. One of the most common errors I hear from those who follow Muhammad is, Jesus never said, I am the Son of God. Well, honestly, the answer to that is very simple, because it is in black and white. John 10:36, Say ye of him whom the Father hath sanctified and sent into the world, Thou blasphemest, because I said, I am the Son of God? So right there, Jesus states, Because I said, I am the Son of God. So can anyone doubt Jesus said, I am the Son of God? And if you think I have pulled this verse out of context, send me a message. I'll be happy to do another video about the whole passage. But after I show the previous text, the question generally changes. Well, Jesus never said, I am God. And I understand the need to change the subject. And I'll be happy to address the diversion in a moment, O Muslim. But before I do, I want to take a moment and challenge you, O Muslim. I did not say insult, and it is not my intent to insult. I want to say first that I think if you call yourself Muslim, I believe you are sincere. I believe you are honestly trying to submit to Almighty God. And because you have been told that Muhammad is the last prophet, you follow Muhammad's message to the best of your heart. In my heart of hearts, I think you are sincere. You want to please Almighty God. Well, brother, I want you to understand something. Almighty God loves it when you seek to know Him. Almighty God wants you to read the message of the prophets. Almighty God sent the prophets to teach you. And there are at least three other prophets who reveal the Son of God. If you do not believe Jesus alone, then believe all four prophets together. I think you want to believe the prophets, but you do not know what they say. So after proving that Jesus said, I am the Son of God, the question nearly always diverts, as I mentioned before. Well, Jesus never said, I am God, and as I have said in other videos, this arbitrary condition is no different. I honestly think it does not matter to those in Islam. If I produced a verse where Jesus said, I am God, Muhammad's followers would change the words of the next demand. Or they would claim, as they often do, that Jesus didn't say those words. The list of excuses to reject the truth appears to be endless. But I would like for you Muslims to ponder something in your heart. Do you want for Almighty God to have to treat you like a child? I am not saying this to be insulting, my friend. I want you to honestly think and search your heart. A donkey or jackass is considered a stubborn and hard-headed animal. Do you sincerely want to be a donkey that God must beat with a stick to get you to obey? I tell you with all due respect, if you demand that God appear and say, I am God, before you will worship Him, you are being a hard-headed donkey. And you may laugh at yourself as you think about that. So did God give any clear signs by the prophets that Jesus is God? Are you willing to allow God to teach you with signs? Or do you want to be a donkey who ignores signs? Does your heart want God to treat you with respect? Or do you want God to beat you with a stick because you are a donkey? The choice is up to you. To be a donkey, or to open your eyes to the clear signs. So please allow me to show you several clear signs which God revealed by His prophets. And I pray that the God of Abraham, maker of heaven and earth, would open the eyes of your understanding. and draw your heart to Him who is the truth. I call my first witness for Almighty God, Prophet Job. Job 9:7, which commandeth the sun, and it riseth not, and sealeth up the stars, which alone spreadeth out the heavens, and treadeth upon the waves of the sea. God is awesome. He commands the sun to rise. God seals up the stars. He spreads out the heavens. And what else does Prophet Job say God does? God treads on the waves. God walks on the water. Who are we talking about here? Almighty God. I hope you understand this means we are talking about God here. And what does Prophet Job say Almighty God does? God walks on the water. I hope you understand this means someone who miraculously walks on the water is God. Now, why do you suppose Prophet Job mentions walking on water? After all, the accompanying list is quite impressive already. He commands the sun to rise. He seals up the stars. He spreads out the heavens. And he walks on the water. Now, why do you suppose Prophet Job mentions walking on water? Can you ever see God commanding the sun to rise? No. As miraculous as it is, we can never see God issue the command and see the sunrise. Can you ever see God seal up the stars, whatever that means? No. As miraculous as it is, we can never see God seal up the stars. Can you ever see God spread out the heavens? No. As miraculous as it is, we can never see God spreading out the heavens. Can you ever see God walk on the water? Yes, you can. And we did see God treading on the waves, walking on the water. Matthew 14:25. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them, walking on the sea. Mark 6:48, and he saw them toiling and rowing, for the wind was contrary unto them. And about the fourth watch of the night, he, Jesus, cometh unto them, walking upon the sea, and would have passed by them. But when they saw him, Jesus, walking on the sea, they supposed it had been a spirit, and cried out. I believe the prophets. I believe Prophet Job. Prophet Job said God walks on the waves. Prophet Job might as well have said, the one you see walking on the water is God. Either you believe the prophets or you don't. I call my second witness for Almighty God, Prophet David. Psalms 89:9, you rule the raging of the sea. When its waves rise, you still them. God is awesome. He rules the raging of the sea. When the waves rise, God stills them. Who are we talking about? Almighty God. I hope you understand this means we are talking about Almighty God here. This is Prophet David in the Psalms that Muhammad claimed Allah sent. I hope you respect Prophet David and the Psalms that Allah sent. And what does Prophet David say that Almighty God does? God stills the waves. And have we ever seen God still the waves? Yes, we have. Mark 4:39, and he, Jesus, arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. What did Jesus do? Jesus did what Prophet David said God would do. Prophet David said God would calm the sea. Prophet David might as well have said, the one who calms the sea is God. Either you believe the prophets or you don't. I call my third witness for Almighty God, two prophets, Prophet Isaiah and Prophet John, or Yahya. Isaiah 43, the voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, God, Yahweh, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Who was Isaiah talking about? The voice who would announce Almighty God. We are talking about the voice announcing Almighty God in the earth, making a path for God Himself. So Prophet Isaiah tells of the voice who will announce God. And who is that voice? Matthew 3:3, for this is he that was spoken of by the prophet Esaias, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, God, make his paths straight. Mark 1:3, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, meaning God, make his paths straight. Luke 3:4, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, God, make his paths straight. John 1:23, he, John, said, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness, make straight the way of the Lord, God, as said the prophet Esaias. Prophet Yahya says that he is that voice, the voice who will prepare the way for Almighty God. Prophet John said that he is the one who will announce God. Prophet John might as well have said, the one that I announce is God. And who exactly did Prophet John, Yahya, announce? Jesus. Now, if you call yourself Muslim, I have a question for you. I have shown you clear signs from the prophets that Jesus is God. Do you believe the prophets? Or do you call the prophets liars? These are clear signs that Jesus is God, my friend. Do you respect God and the signs that God sent by his prophets? Or are you a donkey who listens only to a beating with a stick? I testify before you, O Muslim, that the message of the prophets reveals Jesus is God. And I call heaven and earth to record against you, so that you are without excuse. On the last day, O Muslim, I will stand before God and say, I warned the Muslims, O God, they are without excuse. They have rejected the truth, O God. They have worshipped Muhammad above you, O Most High. O Muslim, do you have any fear of Almighty God? Or do you fear Muhammad more than the God of the prophets? You must decide, O Muslim. I have shown you the clear signs that Jesus is God. The choice is up to you. You may accept God's clear signs, or you may reject God's message by the prophets. I pray that Almighty God would grant you repentance and obedience to his true message. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.